Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can copy or how you can concatenate two files. So first I will be explaining how you can copy the content of one file into another, and then I will be tell you how you can concatenate data of two files, right? So before start, if you go to description of this video, you will find links of various playlists, those are available. So those are related to C language videos, so you can follow them. Now I'm going to explain this first, how you can copy content of a file into another in file handling in C. So here you can see I'm going to declare two file pointers. First one is F1, second one is F2. Right, so F1 will belong to a particular file and F2 will belong to another file, and after that I am declaring a character variable. Now with F1 I am going to open, let's say, data1.txt. This I am going to open in read mode because I am going to read the data which is available into this file, and I am going to open another one as data2.txt, and it will be opened in W mode, right? So here you need to focus. Data1 should be available. If it is not available, then there is no need to copy the data. So that's why it is in read mode. So first you need to create this file on a particular path, and here you can place that path like this. So first you need to mention the drive where file is available, then folder hierarchy, and then name of file, right? If this file is available, then we can only copy content into this. And here for second file I have created this file with W mode. So W mode says if file is not available, it will be created automatically, right? So again, instead of writing data2.txt, you can also write fully qualified path here, so that the file which is present in a particular location, its copy will be created on that location only. Now after writing these statements, we can write F1 double equals to null or F2 double equals to null. So in case if any of the pointer, whether it is F1 or F2, is having null, it means we are trying to open two files, but if any one is not opened with any reason, then there is no need to go further. There is no need to execute further statements. So if this condition is true, you can write files not found, or you can write exit and close this if condition. So if F1 file pointer is equals to null, then it will be executed. If F2 is equals to null, then also it will be executed. And if both are not equals to null, then it will be false and further statement will be executed. So this if condition is very important, because if file is not available, then there is no need to apply the copy of a file into another operation. Now, if this condition is false, it means both the files are available. Now, we can write the statement so that we can copy the data from one file to another. So, I am writing a loop while one. So, whenever we put one into a file, into a while loop, so it means we are iterating this loop for infinite times. Now I am writing this ch equals to fget c f1. So let's say this is data1.txt which is having my name stored, and this is another file data2.txt which is blank. Now if we execute the statement, so fgetc is a predefined function which reads a particular character from file, and which file? F1. F1 is linked with data1.txt. So first character, that is S, will be read, and that will be stored into ch variable, right? Now one more thing that you need to know, after each file eof, that is equivalent to end of file, is automatically available, right? So in string you might have used this null. So null is automatically available after or end of each string. So similar to that, in each file at the end we have one value, that is eof, end of file. So while reading this you can apply this, if ch is equals to end of file. So eof is also a character. If it is equals to this, so you can break the loop, and if it is false then you can write fputc, the character and second file. So this is a small loop which is responsible for copying the content of a file into another. So this loop is repeating infinite time, but this if condition is making it finite. So if character is equals to end of file, so it will be terminated. Otherwise the character which is received from f1 into ch, that will be stored through fputc into f2 file. So one by one each character will be copied into second file, and whenever we will be receiving eof, this loop will be terminated and end of file will be inserted automatically into data2.txt. And after this you can write fclose all. So fclose all is a function which closes all the opened file in the program. So we have opened two files, so both will be closed automatically with this function. So this way I hope you understood how we can copy a file into another, right? Now our requirement is to concatenate. After understanding the copy process, we need to understand the concatenation purpose. So this is also very easy. With the help of this program I am going to explain you how we can concatenate two files. So let's say this is having Sanjay and this file is having Gupta and eof, and we need to concatenate both Sanjay and Gupta together into a file. So let's say I want to concatenate data into this file. So after Sanjay, Gupta will be available. So I need to read this file in R mode, and this file I am going to read in A mode. A mode is for appending. So I am going to append data into data1.txt and reading data from this so that it will be appended here. So now I need to read data from F2, which will be stored in CH, and here I am going to use F1. So F1 is opened in append mode. So initially file pointer will be available at the end of file, and the last name which is stored in data2.txt will be stored after the first name. So this way, by minor changes, by converting W mode into A mode, we are able to concatenate two files, right? So W mode always opens a file, a blank file, and A mode keeps the existing data as well, and it allows you to write data at end of file. So this way you can copy and concatenate two files in file handling. So I hope you understood both the processes, how we can do this. So try to implement this program in your laptop so that you can understand the process. And I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. And if you want to watch more programming related videos, so at the end of this video you will find links of various playlists. Also in the description of this video you will find links of various playlists related to C language. So follow them, and thank you for watching.